Good morning, Dahmina Khan is here. In this video, I will explain a topic of M1 A-level mathematics from CAIE syllabus. It is paper 4 of maths and the topic is energy, work and power. And before I start, you can see the blog address on the top on which you will find all the links of my previously made videos. Okay, so in this video, I will basically explain the concept of the topics according to the syllabus and then one example of each type. And then in my next video, I will take questions from past paper to explain or to show the application of these concepts in those questions. So let's start. In this topic, basically you need to know what is work done, what is gravitational potential energy and kinetic energy, relationship between the change in energy of a system and the work done by the external forces. And then you need to know appropriate cases, used in appropriate cases, the principle of conservation of law of energy and power. So basically, in short, if I say work done, kinetic energy, gravitational potential energy, power, relationship between energy and work done, and the last thing is law of conservation of energy. So these are the concepts you should know and how they are applied. So let's start with work. So basically, work done is force into distance. Usually when you will see the book, it will be written there FD, right? So why I have written here FD cos theta? Actually, it is F cos theta and D, and F cos theta is basically the component of force in the direction of the motion. Now, for example, if you are not getting this, let me explain it. Let's see here, this block is moving from point A to point B. The force is applied in this direction and block will also move in this direction. So right now the force is just 20 Newton. I don't need to take any component of it because force and the motion of the block are in the same direction. So straight away I will multiply force and distance, which is 20 times 5. Just to show you here, because the angle between the direction of the motion and the force is making angle 0. So that's why I have written here 0. Or you can directly write 20 into 5. This was just to explain to you. And the unit of the work is joules. So it is 100 joules. Now let's take this example. Same scenario, but now force is applying at the angle of 30 degree with the horizontal line. So again, you are covering 5 meter and the force is 20 Newton. But as I said, work done is component of force in the direction of the motion multiplied by distance covered. So now you must know by this time how to resolve force vertically and horizontally. So this is the horizontal component moving along the direction and this is the vertical component. So this is 20 cos 30 and this is 20 sine 30, which we don't need basically because motion is happening in this direction. So that's why it will be 20 cos 30 into 5. So the work done will be 86.6 joules, right? So you can say that work done is equals to the component of force in the direction of motion multiplied by distance moved. So it is FD cos theta. Basically, it is F cos theta times D. Now here I'm taking an example with the help of which I will explain you how to calculate the work done by the push force or forward force, work done against friction, work done by the weight of the box. So in the first part, I am taking an example where the box is lying on the horizontal space. Now the question is saying there is a constant force of 20 Newton on the block, right? And it is making an angle of 30 degree in this direction. It is given to you. And when you push a box and the mass of the box is 10 kg, which means it is 100 Newton because 10 into 10 will be 100. So mass is 10 kg. Here I have written the force the weight is the force, right? And when you push a box of mass 10 kg across a rough horizontal floor, so this is a rough horizontal floor. So these are the information I have gotten from the question. So I am putting them down in the pointer form just to make it easy to understand. And the coefficient of friction between the box and the floor is 0.08. And the last thing is the box is pushed 5 meters across the floor. So this was the information given to you in the question. And now the question is asking, calculate the work done on the box by the push force and against friction. Now we know work done is basically force into distance. So let's see here. By the push force, this is your push force basically. Box is moving in this direction. It means you have to look at this component, and this component is 20 cos 30, and the distance moved was 5 meter. It was given to you in the question. So if you have to calculate the work done by the push force, you will write F cos theta into D, which is 20 cos 30 into 5, and you got 86.6 joules. I hope this is clear. Now if you have to find out the work done against friction, actually with these examples we are looking at the concept individually. In the exam or in the final past paper question, these will be merged. So you will see the application over there all together when it is applied in one question. Right now we are dealing them individually because you should know what do they mean. So work done against friction. Now friction is again force, but it is in the opposite direction. Because if box is moving in this direction, friction is happening in this direction. And it was given to you in the question that box is moving with the constant force. Now we know that when object moves with constant force and moving in a constant velocity, then your frictional force is maximum, which is equals to mu r. Yes, we also have this prerequisite knowledge. So when you have to calculate the work done against friction, it will be F into D, which is mu r into 5. And mu is given to you in the question, which was 0.08. Now how will you calculate r and then into 5? Let's go back to the diagram and we will see what is r. Now if you see here, r is the normal reaction of the block and rough horizontal floor, right? So this is your basically r, okay? So now this is pointing upward, this is pointing downward, and there is another vertical component which is 20 sine 30, right? This is also pointing downward. So if it is in equilibrium in this position, like it is not moving up and down, it means this force is balanced by these two forces. So that's why r is equals to 100 plus 20 sine 30, right? So this is how you will calculate r, that r is equals to 20 sine 30 plus 100 into 5. And then you are simply doing calculation and you got work done against friction is 44 joules. Now you will see when you are talking about the pulling force and frictional force is considered as negative, right? So I have not written here, but you will keep this in your mind that frictional force, when you will use in the calculation, you will take as a negative force. Okay. Now the same work done we are calculating, but now the block is on the ramp, right? And the rest of the situation is all same. I have shown you here that now the force is acting parallel to the plane, which is called parallel to the greatest slope, and the ramp is making 30 degree angle. The block weight is acting vertically down, right? When you have to resolve the force vertically or horizontally, in case of ramp, it's always easier to resolve it perpendicular to the plane and parallel to the plane. And that's why I am resolving it like this. because this line is parallel to the plane and this is perpendicular to it. So now, so the situation is all clear. This will be 100 sine 30 because this line is 100 Newton. This is the weight and this is 30 degree. So this line is 100 sine 30 and this is 100 cos 30. So this is the information given to us in the question. And question is further saying that now box is pushed down the slope and it is parallel to the force. Coefficient of friction is 0.08 and box is pushed 5 meter down the slope. And calculate the work done of the box by the push force against friction and weight of the box. So let's see one by one all these. Now these pointers which I have written here, basically I always find it easy that when you read the question, please note down all the important information in pointer. It helps you to retain and to understand also. Otherwise question's length seems so lengthy that it actually frustrates at time or disappoint or little, you know, worry ke, oh my god, we have to read the whole question again and again. So keep noting it down in one time when you're reading it first time. Okay, so now I have to calculate the work done on the box by the push force. Now the push force was what? 20 straight away. It was parallel. So now to calculate the work done, what will I do before I show you the solution? Simple force into distance. So it is 20 into 5, which is 100 Newton. Now let's calculate the work done by the or against friction. Now because it was written here, the box is sliding down, right? So maximum friction is working. So maximum friction is mu r. Mu was 0.08 and r was 100 cos 30, which is 6.93. So when you're applying the formula, work done is force into distance. So simply substituting the values and then you got 34.6 joules. When question says work done by the weight of the box. Now let me show you the diagram here again. Of course, work done is force into distance, right? Now, in the diagram here, this is the weight of the box and this is the force parallel to the plane. And this force is 100 sine 30. So that's why this is the force I will take in place of F, I mean force weight of the box, and then multiplying it by 5 because it is covering 5 meter. So it will give me 250 joules. So I hope this is also clear to you. Okay. Now we will see energy. What is energy? So energy is defined as the ability or capacity to do work. This is a simple simple definition of energy. So the body, the ability of the body to do work is defined as energy. And in this topic, we study two types of energy. What are those? Kinetic energy and gravitational potential energy. There are many forms of potential energy, but we focus on gravitational potential energy. So let's come to kinetic energy. The kinetic energy is due to the motion of the body. When the body moves, it possesses energy, and that energy is half mv square, where m is your mass and v is your velocity, right? And then comes to gravitational potential energy. So gravitational potential energy is due to the position or position of the object from the ground, above the ground. And if there is any level which you are taking as a reference level, then below it, it will be minus h and above it, it will be plus h. So it depends what is your reference level. Usually we take it from ground. But in the questions, you will see in the past paper question, it is any reference level from where we are talking about the height above or height below it. So the gravitational potential energy is mgh, where h is the height, g is the gravitational force, which is in the syllabus we take as 10 meter per square second, and m is the mass. And one thing you must know, that mechanical energy is basically is the total energy of a system due to its position and motion. So whenever we will talk about mechanical energy, it means we are talking about both kinetic energy and potential energy, and you will see the application of it. Now let's see what is the work energy principle. Actually, these little information and formula you have to remember, because altogether they will be applied in the past paper question and you will understand then why we are doing what. Okay, so the work energy principle says that the total work done by the forces which are acting on the body is equals to the increase in the kinetic energy of the body. So in simple language, if you want to find the total work done by the force which is acting on a body, we will just see how much kinetic energy has changed in that body, that is equals to the work done. And we will see one example which will help us to understand this formula. So before that, I would like to see how we have derived this formula, the proof. It's not part of the syllabus, but just for the information, because it makes more sense. It makes more easy for us to understand. Okay, so proof is, how did we get this? Work done by a constant force. So we know F is equals to ma, right? Newton's second law of motion. So if I make A a subject, it will be F over m. We also know it is V square equals to U square plus 2as when there is a constant acceleration, right? And if I make or substitute this value in place of A, so after that, simply cross multiply, take m here and bring 2 down here. So it will be half mv square minus half mu square equals to fs. Now fs is force into distance, which is equals to work. This is how we have derived this equation of work energy principle. Now let's see the application of it in one of the question, where we will show that work done equals to increase in kinetic energy of the body. Okay, so in this question, it's told to you that the mass of the cyclist and her bicycle is 65 kg. And it was accelerated from rest to 8 meter per second. And distance covered was 80 meter on the horizontal road. You have to calculate the work done by the net force. So it is started from rest. It means initial velocity was 0 and final velocity was 8. Mass is given to you 65 kg. So work done is equals to this. I'm simply applying the formula half m v square, final minus initial. So I got this work done in joules. Now the next part of the question is saying calculate the net forward force. So the cyclist and the cycle itself, which is moving forward. So there is some net force, forward force applied on it, right? So we have to calculate that forward force. So we know work done is equals to force into distance, which is this. And work done we have just calculated because of the increase in kinetic energy in the body, which was 2080. And distance was 80 meter. So the force is 26 Newton. So you have calculated the forward force. So you can see how we have calculated in this question the work done and the net force, forward force. Okay, so now only two things are left: law of conservation of energy and then power. Now let's see the formula. Now this is all about it, where students usually get confused, whereas it is very simple. You just have to be careful about sign and the simple basic formula. Law of conservation of energy. Actually, by the way, the word conservation, conservative forces, you need to know all that. I'm not going into the detail, maybe in my next video, because the length of this has already gone to 19 minutes. So otherwise you can also Google, because you need to know the meaning of all this. It is not asked, but still. Anyway, so law of conservation of energy says, like, conserve mean retain, not changing, right? So it means whatever is the kinetic and potential energy at initial point will be equals to the kinetic and potential energy on the other end if the surface is smooth. But if it is rough, then there is some work is done on the way to overcome those resistances, right? So that's why it is said the initial mechanical energy plus work done is equals to total mechanical energy at the final stage. So I is for initial, F is for final. I will take an example to explain this. So let's see. But remember this formula, law of conservation of energy formula, that initially the total mechanical energy, which means kinetic and potential, plus the work done, it is non-conservative forces basically, which is friction, for example, right? So work done against friction, and then total mechanical energy at the last stage where the object is reaching or going. So let's see in the example and it will make more sense. Okay, so this is the question, and I have tried to explain or the drawn it so that I don't need to write the whole question in detail. Okay, so what is the situation? This block is going up from here to here and it is projected with the velocity 5.6. So this is your initial velocity, and by the time the block will reach here, the velocity will be 0 meter per second. Okay, and the weight of the box is not given, so I'm just writing M is the weight. And why did I write G? Because to change it into force, M is mass and weight is mg, right? And what else is given to in the question is that tan theta equals to 4/3. Theta is not given, so I can calculate with the help of this sine theta and cos theta. So this is the situation of the question. So just to show you, how did I calculate cos theta and sine theta? If tan theta is 4/3, then by Pythagoras theorem, you can find this out, 5. So cos theta will be 3/5 and sine theta will be 4/5. We will need that in the working later on. Okay, so the surface, this plank or this ramp is rough. So coefficient of friction is 4/7. And like I said, body is projected with the speed of this. It is a rough inclined plane. And the distance is S, which you have to find out. Right? So the whole question is clear to you. Now let's see how we will find it out. Sorry, let me just see here. Okay, so like the formula of law of conservation of energy, I told you it is total mechanical energy plus work done is equals to total mechanical energy at the end. Now in this case, the work done is against friction force only, okay, against friction. So mechanical energy is kinetic and potential, gravitational potential energy, and same is here. So this is the formula I have written. Minus sign I have told you because work done against friction, friction is in the opposite direction, so it will be negative. Now why did I write mu r? Because this is the maximum friction which will be used during the motion. Okay, so now after that, I'm just substituting the values here. Mass I don't know, so I will leave it as it is. But my v square, basically it is u square, right? So let me write here u in case if you get confused. It is actually u, the initial velocity, right? So I will write here 5.6, and here I will write 0. Now mass I don't know, g is 10, and what is my height? Initially it is 0, so this term will become 0. Mu is given to you in the question, which was 4/7. If I did not tell you earlier, so now I'm telling you, mu is given to in the question. R is basically this value, and this is equals to this, and this I got from the resolving the weight. So if this is M, if I resolve it perpendicular and horizontal to the plane, this will be mg cos theta and this will be mg sin theta. I hope you know how it is. It's a simple trigonometric ratio saw ka toa. This is m, this is a. So if I don't know this, I will apply cos rule. Cos theta equals to this over m. So I'm getting it from there. You know, this is a prerequisite knowledge. I hope you already know this. Okay, so I am substituting the values here now. Nothing else I am doing. Kinetic energy, potential energy is 0. 4 over 7 mg cos theta s. S is the distance of the ramp which we have to calculate basically. And on the top, when the velocity is 0, your kinetic energy is 0. And this is your potential energy on the top. So we already know the value of cos theta and sine theta. So I am simply substituting those values and doing algebraic calculation here. Right? So when I'm doing this algebraic calculation, it will become this. So you can pause the video and do the calculation yourself to see. So the ramp length is 1.4 meter. Okay, so this is the last topic or the last concept of this topic, energy, work and power. So what is power? Power is the rate of doing work for a system. Simple definition. And in other words, power is the rate at which energy is being spent. So formula wise, if I see, by the way, power unit is watt, right? So rate of work mean work done divided by time. Work done is in Newton meter. And time is in second. Now work done is equals to force into distance. We all know. Actually, we are driving two formula here, which we will use in the question, right? This is what I'm trying to do here now. I know power is rate of work. Work done divided by time. And work done is actually force into distance. And I know, you know, the distance over time is speed. So power is equals to force into velocity. Speed is magnitude, velocity is direction. So basically the formula is power is equals to force into velocity. So if you have to find out force at times when power is given, velocity is given, you can manipulate this formula. It will become power divided by V. So this F is equals to P over V is frequently referred as the tractive force. Tractive force means the force applied by the engine, or if you are talking about truck, whatever. So the force exerted by the engine, right? So let's see the example here of power. Simple example where we will apply the two formulas we have just seen. Okay, so I have drawn here this diagram after reading the question rather than writing the whole question here in Word, which seems quite boring. Okay, so the car is exerting a power of 5 kW, yani ke kilowatt, which is actually equals to 5000 watt, and the mass of the car is 1200 kg, and there is a constant resistance to motion which is 325 newton. You can see here, and this will be my R, normal reaction. Okay, so this is the situation, and I would recommend when you read questions, if diagram is not there, always draw a rough sketch. It helps you a lot to understand immediately. This visual image is very, make your question very easy. Okay, so the first part of the question is saying find the acceleration of the car when the speed is 8 meter per second. Now whenever the word acceleration come and the constant resistance for the speed is constant, everything. So the first thing comes is the Newton's second law of motion and other formula of constant acceleration. Okay, so the power is given to you here, right? Force, do you know force? You don't know force, but you know velocity. Velocity is 8 meter and power was given to you, what was it? 5000 watt. So if you divide power by velocity, you will know force, the forward force which is due to the engine, right? So using F is equals to ma, the force you have gotten from here and mass of the car is given to you, so you can calculate acceleration. But you notice there is something wrong in this. I have made this mistake intentionally to see how many of you can notice it. What is missing here? If I'm saying F is equals to ma, this is your forward force, right? So I have to subtract what from here? The resistance force. Yes, because it's not only forward force, there is resistance force also, which was 325. So from here I will minus 325 and then make it equals to 1200 A. So always remember these things. These are the common mistakes made by students. Okay, so now after calculation I got the acceleration, which is 0.25. The second part of the question is saying find the maximum speed of the car. Now we know that at maximum speed acceleration is zero, right? So now if you apply the formula F is equals to ma, your acceleration is equals to zero. So now it will become, by the way, this I have written v, because now I have to calculate the maximum speed. So I'm simply solving this equation. Force we have just seen is power divided by velocity. So we have to calculate the velocity at which the speed is maximum, and at maximum speed the acceleration is zero. So I got v equals to 200 divided by 13, which is 15.38 meter per second. So with this I have completed the concept we need to know in the topic energy, work and power in M1 A level mathematics. In my next video I will try to take different type of question which can help you to understand the application of all these concepts which you have learned in different scenarios, and at a time 2 or 3 concepts. So thank you very much for watching this video, and please press like and subscribe button so that you get an intimation of my next video. Thank you.